I'm coming from Madrid, Spain. I'm born over there. And I'm coming for a family of five. We were five, one brother and four sisters, including me. And I come from a family that was, money-wise, there was not a high level. But in love, we were very lucky. When I decided to become a sister, the only thing was in my mind is to make a commitment. And to make that commitment to the church, because God needs people to do it, things for Him. And I feel a privilege, because I thought so many people in the world, and He chose me. He asked me to become a sister. Yes, I responded, but He called me. So I thought it was a blessing for my family and for myself. When I was 12 years old, I had the opportunity to meet the missionary sisters, Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, that are a member today. And our sister, that particular sister that I met for the first time, she inspired me. That was an inspiration for me, because I saw her, she was a younger lady, she was maybe in the 20s, and I was 12, but I can see the enthusiasm. I can see where they was in the night, cold weather, bad weather, whatever, they was going and helping people. Not thinking on the person, thinking on the people that they was going to serve in. And I want to be somebody like that one day. My formation time was in Madrid, in Spain. And then I had to study 4 years in French. And when I finished my last year, they asked me to come to the United States. And I said, what is that? So in 2002, May 15, we were able to open this place. And it's a blessing. And it's very sad that we had to have a place like this one open, because it's mean the society is not doing right. We abuse the minors. But I don't like to be negative with this. So to put positive, I think it's a blessing that we had this program in this area in these days. That we can offer the kids stability, no fear, that they can go to bed with no fear, that they can go to sleep peacefully. And the main thing for us, from the board, from the staff, from myself personally, is to make a difference in a child's life.
Her faith and really her commitment for helping the abused and neglected children makes all of us better people. You know, we cannot help but rally around her efforts and helping these children. And again, her faith really is a big motivator to us.
Oh, she's an outstanding person. She's outgoing, very loving, very caring, gives the guidance to the kids. Anybody that walks into the ARC is, you know, it's there. She's there for them.
To me, Sister Milagros is my friend, who happens to be a present-day saint here on earth doing God's work. If you get to meet her, please do so, because she truly is an awesome person.
And she's just a lovely person that she's also very plain and simple. She has no possessions. She believes in her vow of poverty, you know, which she takes, you know, all her vows really into consideration that they're required to take as a religious.
When you make a commitment, or when I make the commitment to become a sister, I want to make a difference in the life of others. And the way that I treat people is how they are going to know God is with me.